Coal seam gas has been part of Australia's energy mix since it was first produced in Queensland in 1997, and development of the resource has been steadily increasing since then. Coal seam gas is mainly methane found within coal deposits trapped underground by water pressure. To access the gas, a well is drilled, anywhere from 300 to 1,000 metres deep through various layers of rock to the coal seam. To protect groundwater from being contaminated, the well is lined with cement and steel casings. Water, already in the coal seam, is pumped out to release the trapped gas. If water and gas don't flow freely, hydraulic fracturing, also known as fracking, may be used to increase the rate of flow. Hydraulic fracturing involves perforating the casing at different levels along the well to gain access to the coal. Water containing chemical additives is pumped under high pressure down the well, opening up existing fractures and creating new ones. Proppant, such as sand, is then added to the water that flows through to the fractures. The sand keeps the cracks open, allowing the gas to flow to the well and up to the surface. Produced water and gas are pumped to the surface and separated at the well head. The extracted gas is processed and transported for domestic and international use. Produced water is treated to remove salts and other chemicals, and then either reused or disposed of according to state government regulations. A source of concern is that hydraulic fracturing fluids may leave the coal seam and enter freshwater aquifers, which are layers of porous, permeable rock that allow water to flow through easily. This risk is reduced by layers of rock with low permeability, known as aquitards, which limit water flow and can act as a barrier. Contamination of groundwater is more likely to occur as a result of accidental surface spills or leaks of produced water and hydraulic fracturing fluids. Another impact is the lowering of water levels in aquifers. Removing large amounts of water from the coal seam decreases the water pressure within the rock layer containing coal deposits. Water in the aquifers can then move towards the coal seam. Just how fast and far this happens depends on the type of and connectivity between the aquifers and aquitards. Other potential environmental impacts include the industry's greenhouse gas footprint, fragmenting of local habitat, and changes to agricultural landscapes and rural communities. CSIRO is conducting research to better understand the impacts of coal seam gas development and develop sound technologies and practices to ensure socially and environmentally responsible development.